Well, hello there. How's everybody doing today? Hopefully good. It is a brisk 9 degrees today. Well, it's 9 degrees actual temperature. It's 5 degrees feel-like temperature, which we're going to talk about later on tonight. I want to get in depth on this actual temperature and feels-like temperature. Today's goal is going to be Kansas City, Missouri. We are running from Sioux City, Iowa, Kansas City, Missouri. Quick trip. It's only about shy of 300 miles down to Kansas City from here. And that doesn't deliver until about 1 a.m. So we're going to run up to the yard. We're going to grab that loaded trailer. Luckily, it is loaded and ready. I just need to go drop that one off. But first, we're gonna go across the street to Burger King. Give me a Whopper. I'm hungry. Alright, see you guys in a little bit. So, temperature is 12 degrees. Then they put that little thing under there that says feels like 2 degrees. I know the science behind the feels like temperature and the actual temperature. Not foolish. But let's cut the crap. If it feels like 2 degrees, it's 2 degrees. It's not 12, it's 2. I don't care what it feels like on the truck or what it feels like on a trailer or the house or a tree. It feels like it's 2 degrees. It's 2 degrees out, people. Right? Right? Or am I just... Never mind. I could be just going crazy again. It's 2. I'm going to stick with it. I argue with a buddy of mine all the time. Yeah, we call it Kurt's temp. We don't call it the feels like temp. I tell him my temp is 2. He says, so it's 12. Or, you know, so it's the actual temp. I said, no, it's 2. And I'm going to stick with it. Like right now, it's 2. I'm cold. I'm going to go get back in that truck, hook it up to one of those trailers, and we're going to run down to Kansas City. Reload is right back in Kansas City. We're going to take it up to Beresford, South Dakota. All right, let's get at it. Can't do it one-handed. Give me a minute. let's try this again. I don't want to talk about it, why we're trying this again. So if you're wanting to know why I'm trying this, you're just going to have to go to Facebook. That's right. I opened up yet another Facebook page other than my personal one. I started one a while back for my trucking one, but I opened up another one for this. All you got to do is get on Facebook, go to Trucking with Schmidt. That is Trucking with Schmidt. And I will explain in that a little bit behind the scenes of why I'm having to try this again. Well, we're going to swing into this truck stop here. I call it the truck stop on the hill. It's right off of 29, all about 5 miles south of Mountain City, right before you get into the hills. I don't know if it really has a name. I think it's just 66. I don't know. They renovated it. I think it has new owners, and they renovated it all up, and it's pretty nice. We're going to swing in here real quick. I've never really figured out if this is the right way to go into the truck stop or if that road back there was. So I always just go in this road right here. And it works out pretty good for me. No one's yelled at me. Oh, that's a big bump though. No one's yelled at me. But we're going to stop in here real quick. Grab a cup of coffee because I need a little go-go juice. Like I said, I'm going to swing in here quick, grab a cup of coffee, and I'll be right back with you. Gotta stay beautiful. Good. I can't lie, guys. That's not coffee. Coffee tastes like crap. I can't stand the taste of it. That is cappuccino with just a little bit of hot chocolate in there with about 5 ice cubes. It's really good. Ugh. I can't believe I actually told you guys I wanted to go in and get a coffee. Alright, 90 miles left. What we're going to do is we're going to stop there, kick this load off. Reload is right there in Kansas City. It's set up for 8 o'clock in the morning. Damn morning people, don't they know that us normal people don't like mornings? Got a story for you. I'm sitting in the living room with my tater tot. She looks over at me and says, "Hey, hand me a bookmark, please." I started crying. I started bawling. She's been my daughter for 14 years. And she thinks my name's Mark. Sad day. Sad day. That's funny, right? Right? Alright, we got a truck now. We have things to do. Talk to you in a little bit. I swear I'm not gonna go crazy. I promise I'm not just gonna snap and kill somebody. No, I'm not gonna go crazy. Guess what? Name of the game this week is Schmidt gets to wait. Which is okay. You know, I can't load till tomorrow morning down here in Kansas City. We got down here in Kansas City and I'm gonna have to wait again. It's all right. We're gonna take our 10-hour break right here. Then we're bounce over, grab that other load. It's only a couple miles from here, so there's no reason to cry over it. But I did wake up this afternoon, so I could have a long night of just staring at my phone. You know, that brings up another question. Here. This is what we're going to make the question of the day. I'm going to switch arms because I tried holding it with my left arm. Let's face it, my left arm is very weak. Alright, here you go. A little bit shaky. Alright. The question of the day is, what do you do to relieve stress? You know, I got a lot of friends on Facebook. I got a lot of friends. Or not friends. Okay, let's back up. Let's retake. I have a few friends driving truck. I know that there's a few subscribers on this channel that are not truck drivers. So what do you do to relieve stress at home, in the truck, in your car, at work? If you just want to snap and freak out, but instead of snapping and freaking out, you got to stay positive, because if you don't stay positive, the world will eat you up, right? Isn't that what everybody says? Really? I'm in Kansas City. All right, let me see if this will catch it. See that? It's snowing. It's not supposed to snow in Kansas or Missouri, I guess. Kansas City. No, I'm in Edwardsville, which is Kansas. It's not supposed to snow. All right, off topic. Crap, what was the topic? Huh. Oh yeah, the question. What do you do to relieve stress? The comments below here, if you scroll all the way down through all the videos, there's a section down there that you can leave comments. Throw a comment down there, let me know what you do to relieve stress. To relieve tension, to not be angry. And a little reminder, I don't know if this is my checking out for the night or not. I might do some stuff in the truck before I try to sleep. But just in case this is me checking out for the night. If you like the video, thumbs up down there. Give it a thumbs up. Please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to, go ahead and subscribe to it. I think it's going to turn out pretty good. I do. I have high hopes for it. I'm loosening up in front of the camera a little bit more. A few friends who think I'm a little weird now. Oh wait, they already knew I was weird. See that? Butler. Little Butter get that when he's watching it later on. Alright guys, just in case this is me checking out for the night, I'll talk to you guys later on. Sweep, sweep, sweep. All day long I'm gonna sweep, 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 and I sing this song. You guys didn't hear that, right? I am just a fully grown man down here sweeping my floor. You were supposed to be gone already. Alright, like, subscribe, you know the routine. See you tomorrow morning.